Now let us discuss the concept of momentum. Before actually going into the concept of momentum, let me give few examples which make you to understand this momentum concept very clearly. Okay, for that what you have to do is you assume that you are standing on ground like this. You are standing on ground like this. Now one of your friend throw a cricket ball of mass m with a velocity v on you. Then what will happen? This ball will move towards you and hit you. Okay, when this ball hit you, what will happen? It creates some impact on you. Okay, it creates some impact on you. This is one case. So now here what happened? He throwed this cricket ball with a velocity v which is equal to, take for example, 1 meter per second. Now let us go to the other example where you are standing on the same ground and your friend who is on the opposite side is again throwing the same cricket ball whose mass is m, similar to previous mass. Now in this case he is throwing it at a velocity of v which is equal to 5 meter per second. Okay, now what happens? This cricket ball will move towards you and hit you. Now what happens? There will be some impact of this when this ball hits you, there will be some impact. Now the question is, the impact here will be different from the impact here. Okay, the reason is here the velocity is more. Okay, next. Now let me change this example. See, now on the same ground again you are standing. On the same ground you are standing again, and your friend who is on the opposite side, now what happened? Initially he threw cricket ball of mass m with a velocity of 1 meter per second, similar to our previous example, similar to this example. Then what happened? This cricket ball will hit you. It creates some impact on you. Okay, this is first case. Now the next case is similarly. Now initially what did he do? He threw a cricket ball on you. Cricket ball on you. Now what did he do? He threw a tennis ball on you. Okay, where we can clearly say that the mass of tennis ball is greater than the mass of cricket ball is greater than the mass of tennis ball. But in both cases, what did he do? He threw, that is cricket ball and tennis ball, with same speed, that is 1 meter per second. But the only change is the mass of cricket ball is greater than the mass of tennis ball. Now what happens? Initially cricket ball hit you, which hit you with a velocity of 1 meter per second. Next tennis ball hit you, which hit you with a velocity of 1 meter per second. Now the question is, the impact on you will not be same in both cases. In both cases means when cricket ball hit you and tennis ball hit you. Okay, the impact will be different. Now if you observe this example, in this example mass is variable. Okay, since mass is variable, impact on you change. Okay, now if you come to this example, what happened? Mass is constant, both masses is constant, but which one is variable? Velocity is variable. Velocity is variable. And again here also you can observe that the impact in both cases are different. Okay, so finally you can come to a conclusion like that: the impact of an object depends upon not only velocity or not only on mass, but it depends upon both mass and velocity. Okay, for this I'll say an example, other example, where you can understand that impact depends on both mass and velocity. Okay, the an example similar to this. Now see, the same, you are standing on horizontal ground, you are standing on horizontal ground. Now your friend is on the opposite side. Now what did he do? First he threw cricket ball whose mass is mc with a velocity v1. Okay, next he threw a tennis ball whose mass is mt with a velocity v2. Now if I ask a question that in which case impact will be more, means you can't say. Why? Because you don't know. Okay, anyhow we know that mass of tennis ball is greater than mass of cricket ball, but you don't know about their velocities. whether V2 is greater than V1 or V1 is greater than V2. Now in this case, what happened? You can't assess the impact. Okay, so that, why? Because impact depends upon product. Impact depends upon both mass and velocity. In this case, you can come to a conclusion that MT is greater than MC based upon our general observation. But you can't come to a conclusion whether V2 is greater than V1 or V1 is greater than V2. So we cannot say that in which case impact is more. Okay. Now, so this impact, the impact, that's what he's saying. The impact produced by an object depends on their mass and velocity. It doesn't depend upon only mass or only velocity. It depends upon both mass and velocity. Okay. This impact is nothing but momentum. Okay. Now, the other way of expressing momentum is nothing is it is the quantity of motion contained in a body, or it is nothing but the amount of movement contained in a body. That is called as momentum. Now, how will you define momentum? Momentum is defined as the product of mass and velocity. So, now momentum will be denoted by symbol capital P. Okay. It is defined as the product of P is equal to mass into velocity. Okay. So the formula for momentum is P is equal to mass into velocity, or the product of mass and velocity. Now, if you observe this formula, mass is a scalar quantity, but velocity is a vector quantity. So finally, what we can say? We can say that momentum is a vector quantity. Next, the vector quantity means it will have magnitude as well as direction. Okay, it will have both magnitude and direction. Now the question is, what is the magnitude of momentum? The magnitude of momentum is nothing but mv. Next, what is the direction of velocity? What is the direction of momentum? The direction of momentum is nothing but the direction of velocity. That is, momentum always lies along the direction of velocity. Okay, that's what written here. Its direction is same as the direction of velocity. Okay, the final conclusion is momentum always lie along the direction of velocity, and its magnitude is nothing but m into v. Okay, next, coming to units of momentum. So the SI unit of momentum is, so what is the formula for momentum? Momentum P is equal to mv. If I want to be very perfect, I have to write like this. Momentum is a scalar, so I have to represent by an arrow. P bar is equal to mass. Momentum is a vector, so I represent with bar. P bar is equal to mass is a scalar, no problem. Velocity is a vector, V bar. So finally, means if I had to be very perfect, I had to write like this. P bar is equal to m V bar. Okay. Now come to the unit of momentum. The unit of momentum is kg meter per second. We know that the SI unit of mass is kg. Okay. And the SI unit of velocity is meter per second. So if we combine this, what will I get? The SI unit of momentum will be kg meter per second. Okay, next. The next point is, we already know that force will change velocity. Okay, means force will force will change the value of velocity. Okay, I should not say it as value. So to be perfect, what I have to say is force will produce some change in velocity. What do you mean by producing some change in velocity? It means that this force can either change the direction of velocity or magnitude of velocity. Okay, so if out of these two, if any one happens or both happens, then we can say that velocity is changed. Now, so what am I saying? I'm saying that force produces change in velocity. Now, if velocity is changed, that is, in P is equal to mv, if v is changed, what will happen? Momentum will also be changed. So finally, what can I say? Force will produce change in momentum. Okay, that's what written here. Since the application of an unbalanced force, that is important. Unbalanced force means is the force where its net value is not equal to zero. Now see, since the application of unbalanced force brings a change in velocity, that's what I said. An unbalanced force acting on an object or any system will produce change in velocity. Okay. Since the application of unbalanced force brings change in velocity of the object. Now, if velocity is changed, what will happen? Momentum will be changed, because the reason is P is equal to mv. If v changes, P also changes. That's what written here. It is clear that force also produces change in momentum. Okay. So, since force is changing velocity, that means force is also changing momentum. Finally, the conclusion is, if I want to produce a change in momentum, what I had to do? I had to create some force, or I had to apply some force on the body or system. Then what will happen? The momentum of the body or system will change.